views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
Welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio, harnessing our connection with the universe to affect change for optimal success and happiness. Are you looking for direction with your relationships, business, purpose, or simply life? Well, you're at the right place. Named one of the country's top psychics, Eve now brings her insights and gifts to this weekly hit call-in show, joined by visionaries, leaders, gifted others, but mostly you. Get ready for a slice of life's journey, Eve's objective guidance, tarot, readings, and the momentum you need to move beyond whatever crossroad you're stuck at. Now here's your amazing host, Eve.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio, harnessing the power of the universe for happier living. My name is Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. Thrilled to be here today. I have a fantastic guest coming on in just a few minutes. Plus, we'll be doing readings together in the second half of the show. Benny, thank you so much for producing the show, and thank you one and all for tuning in. My guest today, who I'll be bringing on very shortly, is Pamella Horton, who has a special method for helping people live their lives with true authenticity. She is also the host of the Calling the Real You podcast, which I had the great honor of being interviewed for. It was quite the experience, as I'm used to asking the questions, so it was wild to be interviewed by someone else. That show has not yet aired, however, I will be sure to let you know when it does. For today, however, in the second half of the show, I will be doing tarot card readings for you with my guest sharing her perspectives. If you're interested in getting a reading, please give us a call at 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. For those new to the show, just a brief bit about who I am and many, many welcomes. I'm an intuitive coach and professional tarot card reader who works with clients worldwide on tapping into their own strength and power to affect change for optimal success and happiness. This is done by effectively using the universal energy that surrounds us all. In addition, I do speaking engagements and tarot card readings at events nationwide, such as birthday parties, baby showers, corporate events, bridal showers, you name it. In fact, right after we sign off today, I'm headed to do readings at an event, which should be a lot of fun. Last year, I had the great honor of being featured in the book Top 50 Psychics in the United States, which was beyond awesome and humbling. If you're interested in scheduling a tarot card reading with me, you can do so direct on my website, which is www.elitetarot.com or mainstreammetaphysicsradio.com. I was thrilled to be introduced to my guest, Pamella Horton, as we have different approaches, yet from everything I can tell, very similar philosophies. This is why I always love having on guests from different specialties, as there is more than one way to gain insight, and you, as the ultimate consumer, can choose what approach or style best resonates with you. One of the reasons why I really like talking with Pamella is that she is all about living your life authentically, which is truly music to my ears. We all have a unique journey in life that will look like that of no one else on this planet. Yet it is hard to honor that unique style sometimes. This is a topic super close to my heart, as when I decided to become a tarot card reader, I struggled with the decision. I love shiny, tall, modern office buildings and am a type A control freak who truly sees herself as mainstream with an MBA and a comfort with administration and rigorous proof. Now, I also believe passionately in using universal energy and following the open doors and breadcrumbs that are left in our paths and have been a filter of messages and dreams that I have no rational explanation for, yet seem to connect and even sometimes foretell. So you can imagine that to become a full-time tarot card reader was challenging, not only internally, as I had to find a way to justify to myself my doing this work and not reject part of who I am, as well as externally, in how do I do tarot logistically in ways that are authentic to me. Like everyone, I'm still a work in progress, but the more I embrace who I am in the composite of energies, the more I can follow a path of adventure and joy. I always like to come up with a tarot card that best talks to the subject, and the card that came to mind was the Two of Cups. In this card, you see two very different individuals facing each other and offering a cup of unity, love, and harmony to the other. One individual is dressed in regal blue with very little decoration, while the other individual is dressed in a colorful tunic of many colors and a fiery red headband. I consider this the two energies all of us have, masculine, feminine, yin and yang, left brain, right brain. As a composite, you are best served when these energies are all unified with equal power. On the card, there's a twisted snake symbol coming between these two energies, almost as if to separate them, as temptation tends to attempt to do this to all of us. Yet, as a bond, when the full composite of what makes you you comes together, then all I can say is watch out, world. So let me bring on my guest now, as I have a feeling she has also much to say on this topic. So let's get right to this. Pamella Horton is a modern-day spiritual explorer with decades of personal and professional experience, with a bachelor's degree in social work and a master's degree in organizational development. Merging her composite of talents, energies, and gifts, Pamella helps people connect with their source of success in all areas of life. As host of Calling the Real You podcast, Pamella collaborates with visionaries, CEOs, luminaries, lightworkers, and healers. The core of her teachings is that you can lead a spiritual and magical life starting right now from where you are, and that everyone has a unique contribution to our world. So welcome, Pamella, to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Thank you so much, Eve. This is such a pleasure to be here. Hi, everyone.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited you are here. And I have so many questions. But before we get to them, can you just begin to tell us a little bit about your personal journey of honoring your authenticity of purpose?
Absolutely. And Eve, let me just take a moment to thank you so much for having me on as your guest. It's really an honor to be able to share this time and space and energy with you and your audience as well. When it comes to honoring our authenticity, the real you, you know, people have often asked me, what does it mean to call out the real you? And for me, over the years, the teachings, the books, the experiences I've had, I learned that we are all born perfect. If you just kind of imagine yourself when you were a baby or a toddler, and if you can't do that, imagine an image, a picture of yourself when you were an infant or a toddler, and just how perfect you were, whether there was a physical challenge or not. You were born perfect. You were born without any baggage. You were born without any beliefs. You were born without any experiences here in the physical plane. And because of that perfection, you grew into taking on other people's baggage or beliefs or fears or strengths, et cetera. You learn to take on other people's labels that were given to you, whether that be sister, brother, shy one, the beautiful one. It doesn't matter. And we're coming into my own journey of figuring out who I really am and helping others call out the real them. It really is a process of staying in touch with our bodies, actually, first and foremost, and being an observer of what is versus trying to push things to actually happen and unfold. And I'm going to stop right there and see if you have any questions about that.
Yeah, no, I love everything you just said. It suddenly brought to mind the movie The Truman Show, where you believe that you are your environment. and it becomes one and the same. And so it's hard to figure out what part is you and what part is adopted and what you can release and how do you take your own individual stamp to it. Would you say that was appropriate?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, when we are in a moment, when we're living our lives day to day, we are in typically an autopilot mode. We're typically going from one activity to another, one email to another, one phone call from another to another, without really honing in and tuning in to our body, what it is that we're thinking at any given point. But I can assure you all who are listening, every moment of every day, we are thinking something. And that those thoughts are either confirming or denying the beliefs that we've been given or have adopted or we inherited or we formulate for our own. And those beliefs, those filters, are what prevent us from actually being our perfect self. But we're always perfect, and the perfection that is in us is always connected to our source. But we go about life thinking that we can do things on our own and not have any real guided direction or try to force things to happen, putting that square peg into the hole, into the round hole. And when we go about our lives doing it that way, that's when we experience adversity and pain, and more so than usual than what life would normally have to offer. And those filters prevent us from being connected and from being the real us.
Oh, I love that. You know, I always say that we tend to kind of look to the universe for guidance, and then we kind of take our own control and we start pushing forward when perhaps things are not necessarily authentic and organic. And then we kind of find ourselves off track and then get ourselves back on track. And it can be a painful experience when you are not feeling as if you are living that authentic life with ease. You know, we have so much more to talk about. But we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be talking more with my guest, Pamella Horton, about living your life authentically. And we'll be doing readings later on in the show. You're listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason.
Bree Gibbs is a fourth-generation high priestess with the knowledge to raise your vibration and conscious creation. Offering a wide variety of services from goddess light and shamanic healing seminars to private reading sessions, Bree works with you so you too can stand in your own power. Isn't it about time you took your life into your own hands? For more information about Bree's services and products, visit silvergaia.com. That's silvergaia.com.
Wow. Hey, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. This is Talk Radio to Thrive By. I'm telling you, I got to pinch myself some days, because when each of us gets called to do something that we so not thought was in our wheelhouse to do, for a purpose that's so much greater than us, we get to show up and shine.
If you would like to show up and shine on the Dr. Pat Show as a co-host or sponsor, send us an email to inspire@thedrpatshow.com.
Awareness is universal. Establishing a living awareness through meditation brings peaceful, healthy, and creative well-being into your everyday life. The practice of living awareness, Spirit Fire's own meditation practice, is built on this belief and is designed for every level of practitioner. Each year, Spirit Fire hosts living awareness meditation retreats that allow you to explore the practice in depth at our retreat center in beautiful Western Massachusetts. Introduce yourself to meditation and the practice at the Foundation's retreat. Attend, in silence, a silent meditation retreat focused on mindfulness, presence, and nature. Or be engaged with the meditation sittings themselves at the Deepening Retreat. Start adding to your awareness and attend a meditation retreat designed to cultivate consciousness in your everyday life. For details on attending a Living Awareness Meditation Retreat, visit upcoming events at www.spiritfire.com.
Treat the body and expand the soul on June 1st with Lynn Brown. Imagine 3 days in a hand-built log home nestled in the Cascade Mountain. Activate the collaboration between the body and spirit and allow the accelerated connection as one of the most powerful ways to light up your cells, honor the body's needs in this all-inclusive event. Visit lynnmbrown.com or call 206-931-7356.
You, yes, you, can be the highest version of yourself. Wellness coach and natural beauty expert Dr. Agnes Frankel is on a mission to help you play the game of your life. Win in vibrancy, health, and beauty. Because you deserve it. Dr. Agnes goes beyond the limits in her personal coaching sessions to revolutionize health and wellness. Now is the time to unleash your true power. For more information, visit dragnesfrankel.com.
Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot, with my guest, Pamella Horton. I will be doing tarot card readings shortly, with Pamella offering her awesome perspectives. If you're interested in a reading, give us a call at 800-930-2819. If you're feeling disconnected from your life's purpose, at a crossroads, trying to bring healthy love into your life, or anything along those lines, we can look at it all through the lens of the reading. So, Pamela, I've got more questions for you, but before that, could you please share with our listeners how they can learn more about you and connect with you?
Absolutely. I actually would love people to join me on Facebook. It's actually quickly becoming my office. More and more people prefer to even use the messenger when it comes to business. I'm noticing these last several months. And so my name is Pamela, spelled with two L's, and my last name is Horton, as in Horton, here's a who, and you're please feel free to Google or search me out on Facebook there and join me. I also have a Facebook group page for Calling the Real You, and that's all one word. So Calling the Real You, is, and you is capitalized. And then lastly, all of you are definitely welcome to email me at Pamela@callingtherealyou.com.
Wonderful. Well, I love the topic today. It's such a close one to my heart about living your life authentically and embracing your purpose and your destiny. And you, before the break, you were telling us such wonderful ways of kind of tapping into some of that power. How, for you personally, how was your journey? Was it just a straight shot, or did you come upon some obstacles along the way to living your life authentically?
It definitely, no, nothing is ever a straight shot when you're doing this type of work, right? I believe, like, the hardest job in the world is being a parent. It can be the most rewarding and the least rewarding job on the planet, in my humble opinion. But I also believe the second most difficult job in the world is working on ourselves. I feel like it's a responsibility and accountability to really find out where not so much our weaknesses are. I actually don't believe in weaknesses. I believe in gaps. And when we can identify gaps, such as things or blockages or filters that are preventing us from being the real us or living authentically, when we identify those and then actually begin to clear them and operate from them, it can be difficult. And so, no, nothing is a straight shot. For me personally, Eve, I grew up being a people pleaser and a perfectionist. I mean, you know, high honors, worked, you know, part-time throughout high school and college and maintained a great average and went on to being a successful corporate career and then leaving corporate and having multiple businesses, both that have failed and have thrived over the course of the years. And for me, I had to learn how to not say yes so much, how not to, and mean what I mean by that is I believe in saying yes to the universal breadcrumbs, but I don't believe in saying yes any longer to just keeping myself busy and joining or aligning myself with people or businesses or opportunities just because of the sake of saying yes. I feel like actually that pulls you away from your purpose versus keeping you on track. And when I learned over the, what I learned over the years about being a people pleaser and a perfectionist is that it held me back versus propelling me forward into my purpose. And when I began to recognize when I was hearing myself say yes to something that I knew I was going to dread later on, or when I tried to please other people versus asking myself what was going to honor me and my source, my God, my, I believe in God. And when I learned to start to seek source first versus seeking everything else outside of myself, and that didn't really matter, that was just fillers, that's when I began my lifelong journey of authenticity. And it's still, it's a not a battle, but it's a challenge, because you want to do, you want to be successful, you want to be healthy, you want to have make a good living. And so you can get tripped up and not being honest with yourself first and foremost. And that's what authenticity is checking in when a opportunity presents itself, or when there's conflict in your life, checking in with you, going within, being quiet, checking in to see how your body's feeling, what your heart rate's doing. You know, are you tapping your fingers or making your foot move? Checking into these subtle cues to figure out where you are on the scale of authenticity, right? Are you being completely silent and not connected, or are you being 100% the real you? And there's a huge spectrum in between, and where are you in that gauge is a really big thing. And I learned how to do that early on just by checking in, and that helps me stay the course.
Wow. Well, first of all, thank you for sharing that, your story. So often we look at people who seem to have everything put together, and it's as if they suddenly turned a light switch. They woke up, were born, went to school, did it, then boom, they're success. And yet there are all, every one of us has our own unique journey with our own unique challenges. What may come easy for one person may be challenging for another. And no, very few, I can't think of anyone who's just had that straight shot. But it is, I would imagine you would hopefully agree, maybe not, but it was through the failures or the perceived failures, as you mentioned, of some of the businesses that probably give you the greatest tools and gifts. And even though at the time, it probably didn't feel like that. And so thank you for sharing that. And I'm so glad you said yes to coming on the show. But before we get to our break and then the readings, I just want to ask, does everybody have a purpose? I mean, are we all just kind of born, and maybe some of us don't have a special gift, special purpose? Do we all have a purpose, do you believe?
My belief is that we do, Eve. And for those who feel like they don't have a purpose or are lost or can't seem to find their way, exhibited by the lack of communication between you and your higher power, God, whoever, source, whatever language you use, the universe. And we can get bogged down with distraction, and our world is really great at distracting us. And so that's another piece that I meant earlier, that like one of the difficult jobs and yet the most rewarding jobs is getting to know who you really are so that you can live in alignment with that. But I do believe that every one of us has a purpose, and it could be being a mom. It could be being a house cleaner keeper. It could be being a branded celebrity. But we do. We all have our purpose, and there's a way of finding out what that purpose is for you.
Is, you know, I also think that I agree with you, first of all, and that perhaps there's also many purposes, because we all have this kind of unique gift thing and unique composite of those talents, energies, and gifts that are constantly evolving too, because it doesn't mean that you kind of start living your purpose when XYZ happens, but everything is all on this beautiful continuum. We definitely want to talk a little bit more about purpose if we can, but I really also want to get, before the break, I got to get to the podcast. How did you get started with calling out the real you?
Thank you. Yeah. My entire life has been really about advocating for other people, educating people about what is available to them that can help them on their path of enlightenment, good health, both mental, emotional, spiritual, physical, just introducing concepts to people to live a life of connectedness and ease and joy. And years ago, about 8 years ago, literally the name Calling the Real You was downloaded to me. I was trying to figure out what it was. I was trying to figure out what my purpose was, what my role. And this is going back, like I said, 8 to 10 years ago, and not understanding that everything I've done led into my purpose at that time. I didn't realize that. And I just asked, literally, please just send me something so I can begin this process of helping people. And the Calling the Real You just came to me. And I'm a big proponent and student of Abraham Hicks, A Course in Miracles, and of course the Bible. And I really believed that when I asked that question, it was divinely given to me. It felt like a lightning bolt. Alongside the name of my actual business, the umbrella name of Maven's Connections, both were given to me within a week's time, and I stuck with it, and I didn't have anything to put into it yet. It was just the container, and I stuck with it, and tabled it for a little while, and I kept it in the back of my mind, and then as things started to come into place, the more I surrendered, that was when the name actually came to fruition, and I was able to plug the podcast in.
So I love your podcast. I love the show. I've been listening to the interviews that you do, and you have such a wonderful talent of bringing forth the stories. And just I definitely recommend people to listen to the show. Have there been, and I know we have to go to break soon, but have there been any surprises? Has it exceeded your expectations? Is it exactly what you expected going into it?
That's been a journey, constantly learning and evolving there. I thought I was going to head in one direction, spirituality and business, and I completely went into an entirely different direction. And we can talk more about this after the break, but in terms of my career and the journey and why the spirituality and business and Calling the Real You specifically. But I did have a surprise. I never thought I would be rendered speechless. And one of my interviews with Guy Finley, actually, I was literally rendered speechless. I mean, he was such a brilliant interviewee. And I'll be having him back in the next couple of months. We're going to be doing a mini series, and it just completely short-circuited my brain. And so there was a surprise there that I never thought in a million years I personally would ever be rendered speechless, because people have told me that I have the gift of gab.
Well, I love serendipity, and I love the detours and surprises along each of our unique journeys, and celebrating that, because that's where we also develop keys for the future, even if it's not clear at that time. Wow. Well, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to begin right to readings and talking more with my guest, amazing Pamella Horton. So please stay tuned. You're listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
Yeah. I stare at my reflection in the mirror. Why am I doing this to my...
Are you searching? Looking for a sign? A message you need to hear? From the great unknown? From the most mysterious place? That is the most familiar to your soul and the depths of who you are. The universe put someone here to talk to, someone God gave a blessing to, that you may find insight with. TheAngelLady.net. 1-800-323-1790.
Did you know that all of the shows on the Transformation Radio Network are available as podcasts to stream or download?
Really?
Check us out. Go to transformationradio.fm. We have business shows, spiritual shows, energy healing shows, and pretty much everything in between. Something for everyone, guaranteed to inspire, educate, and transform. We are transforming the world, one listener at a time.
Are you feeling stagnant or blocked in your love life?
career, health, or finances? Experiencing difficulty focusing or setting and achieving goals? Tune in to Spiritual Diagnostics Radio with psychic visionary healers Carol Dorian and Justice Welling. Discover the cause and effect of unwanted patterns in life. Tune in every Tuesday at 12 p.m. Pacific on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit spiritualdeed.com.
Interested in deepening your spiritual practice? The School for Esoteric Studies offers online training to spiritual seekers from all paths of life and individual coaching. Our courses synthesize Eastern and Western spiritual traditions based on meditation, study, and service applied to everyday life. To learn more about our courses and services, please visit www.esotericstudies.net.
Discover the healing medicine from the giant monkey tree frog, Cambo. Cambo practitioner Ginny Rutherford and professional psychic Todd Rolson have come together for lively discussions of alternative healing medicines from the Amazon. Ginny and Todd bring you Cambo Talk Radio. Tune in each Monday at 1 p.m. Pacific to hear from guests all over the world with real life stories and the medicinal benefits of Cambo. For more information, visit CamboKiss.com.
Tune in to the Psychic Professor's Show, The Voices of Spirit Radio, with international medium and spirit artist Dr. Susan Barnes on Transformation Talk Radio. Featuring a variety of spiritual topics such as psychic art, spiritualism, EVP, psychic development, and mediumship. This hit call-in show provides listeners with breakthrough wisdom to enliven and enlighten their lives. Visit spiritartgallery.net for show days and times.
I nearly left the real me on the shelf. No, 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 no. The loser in the blur of the stars.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. You can learn more about me or schedule a reading at elitetarot.com. That's ELITETAROT.com or mainstreammetaphysicsradio.com. A reading is done over phone or Skype worldwide and includes a summary of everything discussed, a photo of the final tarot card layout, and a recording of the whole session. As I look at tarot as a visual representation of the unconscious, which is on your side, wants you to be happy, there's nothing scary that can possibly come up in a reading. If you're just tuning in, I am talking with my fantastic guest, Pamella Horton, host of Calling the Real You podcast. Before we get to readings, one more time, Pamela, can you let listeners know how they can learn more about you and hear your fantastic show?
Thank you. Yes, please. I invite you all to join me actually on Facebook, both on the Calling the Real You Facebook page, along with joining me individually. And my name is spelled with two L's, Pamella Horton, and that's Horton as in Horton, here's a who. And then please Google Calling the Real You podcast, and it will pop up for you very easily, and you can see all of the wonderful guests that I've had, just like Eve.
Yay! So, wonderful. Thank you. So let's get to call. So just so listeners know, I have a candle lit, which is my signal to open a session. And I'll be doing a three-card reading today, with the first card representing the current situation, second card representing something challenging or blocking you, and the third card representing advice. After I do the reading, I'm handing it over to Pamela so she can share her own perspective on the caller situation. Before we begin, I always like to start with a small disclaimer that we are not doctors, lawyers, therapists, or realtors, and that a reading should never be taken as a substitute for seeking guidance from a licensed professional. And at the core, these are just cards. They have no power over you. You always have free will. If you're following along with the readings, I'm using the Rider Waite Smith deck, in which you can kind of see online if you do not have a deck with you. So I am shuffling the cards while I greet our first caller, Zara. Zara, welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Thank you so much for taking my call.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Thank you so much for calling. And am I pronouncing your name correctly, Zara?
You are. Yep, you are.
Fantastic. Is there anything you have a question about, would like guidance on?
Yeah. Just wondering about when I will reunite with my soulmate. I was told by a guide that I would reunite with him, but there were just some circumstances, some experiences that we both needed to go through before we could be back together. So I was just wondering if you had a timeline on that.
Well, I can definitely appreciate so much the desire to know when, and I am pointing my finger up to the sky, unfortunately, and I'm saying that is above my pay grade because so much, because that is out of your power and your strength. Yeah. So if I even gave you a date, June something, still takes, that then takes away from your own power and strength of going forward. And because then you're going to be putting so much stock into something that I said, but I wish I knew what the future would hold, but that's just out of my realm. But what I did do was I pulled three cards on looking at what you can do with your strength going forward in terms of honoring the quest for love, honoring the quest for that unity. Does that make sense?
Sure, definitely it does.
Excellent. So the first card that came up was the Emperor. Now, the Emperor is different from a king. I've got four kings and one emperor. And an emperor means that there is a weightiness, more of a seriousness to your life that came about because long, long, long ago, you were given extra responsibility, extra challenges, extra things that perhaps if you could have pushed the reset button and done it over again, you would have enjoyed playing more. But at the same time, you never shirked your responsibility. But because of those experiences from way, way, way back when, it has led to where there's always this energy going forward, just to making sure that everything is done right, everyone else's needs are being taken care of before your own. And it makes it that much harder to embrace kind of doing silly, frivolous things or joyful things, because that always in the brain comes secondary to honoring that purpose and responsibility from the past. Does that resonate with you?
Very much so.
Yeah, you know, and it's just, even though it may feel uncomfortable or unusual to embrace some of that childlike joy that we all have from our inner child, it is so important to do those things regardless, despite you're just having a little bit of an extra pushback mentally from doing that because of that Emperor energy. Something challenging or blocking you is the Ace of Swords. Aces are about beginnings and swords are about taking action. And the thing is that there are some decisions and actions that you are kind of wrestling with that need to be done. And so it's coming up as a block to that Emperor quality, because there's a feeling of like, well, how do I make a decision for me when it may impact everyone else in the kingdom around you? And yet at the same time, if you don't take those actions, then it just kind of makes those feelings of being beholden to others above yourself even more so. But the advice is the High Priestess, and the High Priestess does not come up that often. And when it does, it really talks to your sensitivity. Are you aware that you're very intuitive, very sensitive to other emotions and everything like that?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah. But know that this High Priestess and the Emperor, they go hand in hand, because from that early age, with some of the turmoil and situations, you had to hone that intuitive muscle, which makes you more intuitive. We all are intuitive. Some are more naturally inclined than others. But because you had to hone that for survival, for joy early on in life, it's now yours to keep. As an advice, it is saying, recognize that this is one of your greatest gifts in your cosmic tool chest and is there to be used more so than because I think about the question that you asked about when will I reunite? And I look at that and I say, honor your intuition and your power and your strength to take actions today for your own purpose forward, letting the universe do its job in terms of when, where, how, so you can take that part off your plate. Now I'm going to pan this over to Pamella. I hope that's been helpful. And Pamella, while we have a break in a few minutes, if we need to go over, we'll just put her on hold and we'll come back and talk some more with Zara. So I'm going to hand that over to Pamella for her to offer her perspectives.
Thank you. Awesome. Thank you. Hi, Zara. Thanks for the opportunity for me to do this. So I'm actually feeling more that in the past, recent past, or the current situation, you've been requesting like some infrastructure, or you've been looking for more of a leadership or even in more integrity in your life from either romantic relationships or just even from yourself. And it's kind of interesting that this call today is about purpose and authenticity. And I feel like this individual that your soulmate, that is your soulmate, is actually possibly involved with, is an authority figure or possibly in a government official or maybe a police officer or in the military of some sort. That's actually what I'm feeling. This is a lot of fun, by the way. I'm just letting myself be here and be the real me. And I'm actually really excited for you because your question, while it might be about a soulmate, I'm really feeling the sense that it's about you and you finding and falling in love almost with yourself and learning how to do that and how to appreciate yourself more. I do also feel that with the, I think that there's a strong connection, if you haven't already begun to do this, to have a relationship with Archangel Michael and begin to communicate with him. I feel like a really strong presence there, that you could actually communicate directly with him and that he would be able to lead you in a way that you could actually trust your own instincts on with regards to that. Any questions on that one before I move on to the swords one?
I tried to talk to the angels and guides, and honestly, I just feel so disconnected. I don't feel like I get any response. I just feel like I'm in it on my own, to be honest.
Thank you. You know, first of all, Zara, I'm going to interrupt here for a second and just say thank you for sharing your own kind of stumbles or challenges with that. Would you mind holding on? And we're going to take a break. And then when we come back, we will talk more and we'll finish this up and talk more with Zara. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be coming right back soon. You're listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Put your makeup on, get your nails done, curl your hair, run the extra mile, keep it slim so they like you.
Hi, this is Ted Winslow, founder of SoundSync Tech, the next generation of sound healing frequency technologies. I'm excited to join Dr. Bree Gibbs, host of the Silver Gaia Radio Show, on Transformation Talk Radio. And as a show of appreciation to all the listeners, I'm offering 20% off my sound healing music. Please go to tedwinslow.com and use the coupon code SILVERGAIA. Looking forward to connecting with you soon.
To see your life from an angel's perspective, book a personal consultation with Claire Candy Hoff. Angelic walk-in angel Ariel at Angel Healing House. Candy provides intuitive counseling, Reiki, and angel readings in person in Los Angeles or nationally and internationally via phone or Skype. She will channel the practical tools you need to transform your life. Call now 831-277-3716 or visit angelhealinghouse.com.
Be you plus live your purpose equals joy.
That's the motto of Unstuck Joy with Vicki Todd. Vicki believes you were born with gifts that are meant to make the world brighter. Each show will feature an art visioning journal prompt to help you create your way to soul clarity. If you're ready to get unstuck and create more joy, this show is for you. Tune in every month on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit VickiWorldArt.com.
Are you traveling most of your day? Do you want to take Transformation Talk Radio with you anywhere you go? Well, guess what? There's an app for that. Just go to the App Store on your Apple device or the Google Play Store on your Android and search Transformation Talk Radio. Catch all of our live shows no matter where you are. Thanks for listening.
Treat the body and expand the soul on June 1st with Lynn Brown. In this all-inclusive retreat, you'll treat your body with breakout sessions in the various elements of nature. Enjoy fireside chats while harnessing the healing energy of fire. Allow more light with more ease and activate that connection between the body and spirit. Call 206-931-7356 or visit lynnmbrown.com.
Get ready to experience Truth Talk Radio with host Deb Acker. Tune in to Truth Talk Radio each Wednesday at 3 p.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com to illuminate the truth in your daily life as you experience life, love, and abundance from a whole new perspective. This hit show will leave you feeling lighter and bring you into a place of infinite possibilities every day in every way. Visit TruthTalkRadioShow.com for upcoming transformative topics and guests.
Get your sexy on, don't be shy, girl, take it off. This is what you want, to belong. So do you like you? Do you like you? You don't have to try so hard. You don't have to give it all away. You just have to get up, get up, get up, get up.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot, with my guest, Pamella Horton, host of the Calling the Real You podcast. So right before the break, we were talking and doing a reading for Zara. Zara, are you still with us?
I'm here. Yes.
Excellent. So, so Pamella, you were talking right before the break. I'll hand the phones over to you.
Awesome. Yeah, I was just about to get into the Ace of Swords. My interpretation of this card for you at this time, Zara, is there may have been feelings of, you know, well, maybe I'm not supposed to really have a soulmate. Maybe I'm not really supposed to have this type of relationship that, you know, is just seems to be elusive to me in terms of reconnecting. And I'm feeling like I want to tell you that, you know, you're supposed to move forward with them. Like there's definitely going to be another connection. And I feel like you're not supposed to give up. And yes, are there bumps along the way? You know, can there be minor setbacks in that reconnection? But I really feel strongly that heaven is really helping you along in this process. And it might feel stalled in some ways as well, because I think that heaven or whoever you pray to, your higher power, et cetera, is waiting for the perfect timing. And just as Eve had said earlier, that's above her pay grade. I would never presume to give you a time frame at all. But the challenges that of getting there, of being reconnected, are really preparing you for what's to come and really preparing you to not only cherish your soulmate, but cherish yourself and adore yourself for even further than what you've been able to do up to this day. There might be some minor course corrections, as I mentioned, or bumps along the way. But I think the message from the card, from my interpretation for you in this position, is not to give up. It's coming. It's. I feel like I want to say it's around the corner kind of experience. And I want to see if I could pick up on anything else and offer anything else here. I do get a sense, though, with the swords, as I mentioned, that there's that military connection with your soulmate. And Ace is all about, I think, new beginnings, right? It's number one. I'm making a total assumption here, but that's what feels right to me. And again, like a new beginning, it's going to feel like a very much a new
relationship, even though you're going to be reconnected. And then regarding the, it was
high priestess.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. I would agree with Eve in that this is about you listening to your intuition, and I'm getting the feeling like you really want to trust what's coming in, but you haven't, and they're inviting you to trust yourself. And you mentioned earlier when I'd asked the question, you know, if you had any questions, and you said that you feel like you're asking all of the time, but you're not receiving answers. And from my personal experiences with Source and with Spirit, I want to tell you that they are always answering you, Zara. It may not feel that way. You may be feeling completely disconnected from them, but there are signs and symbols all around you, and you're being invited with this card to open up and begin to see what may not be, what it may not feel like a response as a response, and it is a response, and it's almost giving you permission to, yes, please trust your intuition. Please trust what's coming in. And it's almost about you taking a leap of faith on you. It feels like, again, I think from the first card, the interpretation that I had was it may very well be about your soulmate, a romantic soul relationship. But I also feel strongly that this is about you and your relationship with yourself and how to cut through, you know, the BS that we are bombarded with in life, and how what is being given to us as distractions in life and through life in general, and to be able to tap into the balance of, you know, light and dark and feminine and male energy and positive and negativity, and allowing yourself to be guided to the positive, to your own feminine nature. That makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, I love it. I hope that's been helpful, Zara.
Yes, it has. Thank you both so much.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Oh, you know, by the way, one thing you may want to consider doing is putting down on paper a list of your non-negotiables from your kind of inner child perspective of the qualities that you need in a relationship without the specifics. Because then when you're putting it down on paper, it allows for you not to necessarily, blanking right now, but if, when you put it down on paper, sometimes we compromise in our own brain and overrule things that are important to us, which then makes it even harder to see those signs and symbols that Pamela was so beautifully talking about. And so when you write that down, you're forming a contract with the universe and you're saying, bring this person to me, but you also now have that guide to know what to put your energy in towards going forward and what not. So you may want to give that a try too. Will you please keep us updated?
Sure, I will. Thank you again.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thanks so much for calling. Well, Pamela, I can't believe this hour has gone by so fast. Tell me a little bit more, one more time for our listeners, about how they can find out more about you, listen to the show, all those things.
Come join me on Facebook. Find me, Pamela Horton, Pamela with two L's. There's also a Calling the Real You Facebook page in the community that we all have on Facebook as well. And then, of course, just simply Google Calling the Real You podcast, and it should bring you right to the page that you need to in order to listen to fabulous guests such as Eve.
I loved being on your show, and I will definitely say and let people know when that is going to appear. You can hear me kind of like, I'm not sure how to do this. And so I will definitely let you know. And so before we close, what's next for you on your ever-evolving journey?
My specialty actually is working with corporations, these. Mm-hmm. I design wellness and lifestyle programs for companies and their employees. When we go to work, we tend to not be showing up our best because of life's challenges. You know, we're exhausted because of the energy that we're spending on things that tend to be not so nice. You know, we're stressed about our life, we're stressed about our relationships, and we show up work really at 40% or 50% of in power. And I'd love to be able to educate and offer resources to employees of companies on how they can find their purpose, how they can improve their physical health and well-being and diminish lifestyle diseases, how they can recharge their energy so that they can come to work not only fully charged, but also remain fully charged for their families and their communities. And that's really the direction that I'm focused on. And it's such a joy to be able to align with companies and employees in that manner.
Oh my gosh, I love it. And I hope people will take advantage and contact you and all your wonderful resources. Thank you so much for being on the show today. I really appreciate and having you on.
That was so fast. I appreciate you having me as your guest, and I appreciate everyone who joined us.
Oh, well, thank you. And I want to thank everyone for tuning in to our authenticity show on Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. Thank you, Benny, for running the show. Thank you, one and all, for tuning in. It's a blessing for me to be able to do this show each week, and I look forward to next week's show. Please join me every Thursday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern, with peace and love and gratitude. See you back here next time.
You've been listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio with your host, Eve. Join us Thursdays at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com to harness the power of the universe for optimal success and happiness as Eve continues to take metaphysics mainstream. Until then, learn more about Eve and Elite Tarot at EliteTarot.com. That's EliteTarot.com. See you next week.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.